why you need to be extra conscious with psychedelics. For years, the mental health field has been largely barren of meaningful treatment advances. But now, scientists have new hope in the least likely of places: psychedelic drugs. Recent research suggests that certain psychedelic substances can help relieve anxiety, depression, PTSD, addiction, and the fear surrounding a terminal diagnosis. Psychedelic substances produce unusual and compelling changes in conscious experience, prompting some to propose that psychedelics may provide unique insights into the nature of consciousness itself. Although it is unclear why psychedelics are closely linked to ideas about consciousness, it is possible that something about the subjective experiences of psychedelics themselves shapes beliefs about consciousness. Let's look at what these psychedelics are and how they work, why the authorities have taken a firm stance against them, and whether or not they are right. And why do you need to be extra conscious with psychedelics? Let's find out. Well, questioning whether psychedelics can change the attribution of consciousness to a range of living and non-living things, a study reveals that higher ratings of mystical-type experiences were associated with greater increases in the attribution of consciousness. Indeed, several studies indicate that psychedelic experiences are associated with various belief changes, including the fundamental concepts of reality. If you ask people about psychedelics or LSD, they're going to think about the psychedelic 60s. Timothy Leary, this flamboyant psychology professor who was at Harvard for a few years studying psilocybin and LSD, and then telling everybody that they should take it in a very public way. The drugs kind of escaped the laboratory and were embraced by the counterculture. The result was a full-scale moral panic against the drugs. President Nixon deemed Timothy Leary the most dangerous man in America, which is pretty impressive for a washed-up psychology professor. But before that, there had been more than a decade of very promising research using these drugs in a therapeutic context in a very responsible way. As part of ongoing research into the mechanics of consciousness, volunteers have been given psychedelic drugs and had their brains scanned in a magnetic resonance imaging, MRI machine. The scientists conducting the research wanted to better understand consciousness and find out what the brain is actually doing when it experiences consciousness. By disrupting the way the brain perceives and models the world while awake with psychedelic drugs, such as DMT, researchers can try to understand how the conscious brain works. Studying the effects of psychedelics might be the key to not only understand how consciousness works, but also to treat some of the problems that can affect our waking lives. With psychedelics being proposed as treatments for depression, anxiety, and addiction. So what do psychedelics do in the human mind? The honest answer? Nobody quite understands. We're really just at the beginning of exploring that frontier. But psychedelics appear to diminish activity in one critical brain network called the default mode network. That network is very involved with operations concerning our sense of self. However, with psychedelics such as psilocybin and LSD, scientists can see changes in brain neuron connectivity in the lab within 30 minutes, said pharmacologist Brian Roth, a professor of psychiatry and pharmacology at the University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill. Matthew Johnson, a professor of psychiatry and behavioral science at Johns Hopkins and an expert on psychedelics, said, "One of the most interesting things we've learned about the classic psychedelics is that they have a dramatic effect on the way brain systems synchronize or move and groove together. When someone's on psilocybin, we see an overall increase in connectivity between areas of the brain that don't normally communicate well. Bad trip experiences are common among users of psychedelics. Such experiences are often transformed into valuable experiences through storytelling. Scientists study the significance of stories about bad trips among users of psychedelics. Drawing on narrative theory, scientists describe the characteristics of such stories and explore their effects. In-depth qualitative interviews with 50 Norwegian users of psychedelics revealed that almost all participants had frightening experiences when using psychedelics, and many described these as bad trips. The key feature of a bad trip was a feeling of losing oneself or going crazy, or ego dissolution. Most users said that these experiences could be avoided by following specific rules based on tacit knowledge in the subcultures of users. Possessing such knowledge was part of symbolic boundary work that distinguished between drug cultures, insiders and outsiders. Some also rejected the validity of the term bad trip altogether, arguing that such experiences reflected the lack of such competence. Finally, and most importantly, most participants argued that unpleasant experiences during bad trips had been beneficial and had sometimes given them deep, existential, and life-altering insights. Your first trip may depend mainly on your mindset going into it. Some LSD users say their attitudes or mood before taking a hit of acid dramatically affects what they feel during it. For example, people with a lot of stress or anxiety may have a negative experience. Paranoia and fear may creep in amid the sensationalized sights and sounds. Others may have a very positive experience. This can include experiencing wildly exaggerated surroundings with bright colors, patterns, bursts, and halos. They may have spiritual breakthroughs or feel they've gained a greater understanding of life during the trip. David Nutt, director of the Neuropsychopharmacology Unit in the Division of Brain Sciences at Imperial College London, said, "It creates a very, very disorganized brain, ultimately breaking down normal boundaries between the auditory, visual, executive, and sense of self sections of the mind, thus creating a state of altered consciousness." He further added, "Depressed people are continually self-critical, and they keep ruminating, going over and over the same negative, anxious, or fearful thoughts. Psychedelics disrupt that, which is why people can suddenly see a way out of their depression during the trip. Critical thoughts are easier to control, and thinking is more flexible. That's why the drug is an effective treatment for depression. But each person's experience with psychedelics will be different. Indeed, each trip may be different. One might be very light, but others can take a frightening and overwhelming turn. During this period of tripping or active effects, you may begin to experience sensationalized perceptions of what's happening around you. This can include seeing colors or tasting sounds. Stationary items like furniture may begin to move or swell or shrink before your eyes. Using psychedelics can be fun, spiritual, or educational if you embrace the experience. It can also be scary, especially if you try to control rather than roll with it. Psychedelics are hallucinogens, but they can also cause physical side effects. These can include sweating, dehydration, increased heart rate, increased body temperature, and hypothermia, which can lead to kidney damage. Some psychological side effects may be most commonly associated with an LSD trip, such as synesthesia, or sensory distortion, hallucinations, paranoia, and euphoria. LSD trips may have possible side effects and complications, such as experiencing flashbacks for days, weeks, or even months after a trip. If these become frequent, you may have a condition known as hallucinogen persisting perception disorder. During an episode, you may experience moments of a trip, such as distorted objects, unusual sounds, or strong odors. You can also experience flashbacks from a bad trip. These flashbacks may become upsetting and can even begin to interfere with your day-to-day life. Some research suggests LSD use may trigger schizophrenia in people who are predisposed to the condition. However, this connection remains unclear. Moreover, one person's acid trip can produce very different results from another person's trip. Good trips may seem dreamlike and euphoric. On the other hand, bad trips can be overwhelmingly negative and cause unnecessary fears and anxiety. You may still experience the same effects of the drug, mixed up senses, hallucinations, and distortions. But bad trips can have an element of paranoia, fear, or even depression. Some people may experience overwhelming feelings. They may accuse people around them of negative behaviors toward them. Rarely, these feelings may be so unbearable a person may consider or even attempt suicide. It's not always possible to know what your acid trip will be like. You can go into an experience with acid with good hopes, but ultimately, it's unpredictable. For some people, a bad trip is enough to make them swear off the drug for good. But for others, it's just one aspect of use.